Let's talk about playing VRChat just on your PC. I'm going to walk you through some basics, and kind of get you situated with starting off and for everything VR. So yeah, welcome to VRChat. If everything worked out correctly and you passed the tutorial, as difficult as it was, you should be here. Now, if you already made it to here, you may already realize what the controls are. Obviously, you have your mouse, to look around your world. That's going to be pretty much how you're going to look around and, you know, check things out around you. And then you have WASD are going to be your controls for moving around. You can hold down shift if you want to go a little bit faster. So that's kind of how you move around a little bit faster. But otherwise, WASD are going to be your go-to. You can press C if you want to crouch. So see, I'm crouching. Let me go ahead and I'm going to go up to a mirror just so you can check this out. If you come over here, there's a mirror. So see, C is crouch. And then if you press Z, interesting thing, certain avatars will have different Zs. A lot of the time their Z is going to be them crouching and the camera is going to be like them kind of laying down. But the cool thing about certain avatars, and this is obviously a tip for later on, but if you are playing on PC and you want to kind of like sit down with other people, but you don't want to be like laying down on the ground, certain avatars have this. It's like a squat, or it's like, you know, like a crisscross applesauce motion. And this is nice because it brings you down, it lowers your camera angle, so you can talk to smaller avatars, but also if other characters are sitting down, you can kind of sit down next to them. So it's just kind of nice to have that option. Really, the main thing is your camera angle. You just want to be able to kind of talk to people where they're at. A lot of the times if people have a VR headset, they're going to want to, you know, make eye contact with your avatar. So that's just kind of helpful. So you're in your home world. This is the home world. And if you're noticing that certain objects, when you have this little cursor here in the middle of your middle of your screen, that's your cursor. So you'll notice you can equip certain things. So like if I want to pick this up, this pen right here, I'll grab it once, so it says equip, so I left click to equip, and then I can also left click again to use. So see, I can draw a little blob there, you know, and then when I'm done, I'll right click and it stays right there. So that's how that works with objects. And it's the same thing for pillows and other objects. If you want to hold down left click, that's how you hold it, and that's how you can kind of carry it around. I can show you guys in the mirror here. So see, carrying it around, holding it down, and then when I right click, that lets it go. And you know, obviously if you're not obviously, this is a tutorial, but if you're pretty comfortable with playing games on PC, the format's pretty basic. It's going to be your mouse and WASD, obviously, and then, C and Z for crouch, and then to go a little bit lower. You'll notice in certain worlds, you'll have different avatars you can choose from. So I'm going to go ahead and change my avatar right now. And the way you do it is, in a lot of the worlds, you'll have the pictures of the avatars, and you'll just click on it, and then eventually, after a little bit of buffering, your avatar will load. Maybe this one Z is, oh yeah, there you go. So this avatar has the full Z, that's like them kind of laying prone. And you know, I'm not a big fan of this one because the hand's kind of in the way. But then obviously, C to crouch. She's got her hand up there, and then C again to stand back up. So now I'm gonna go ahead and hit escape. Now, after I hit escape, this brings up kind of your menu for VRChat. So this is how you're gonna navigate to a lot of different things. This is how you're gonna go to different worlds. This is how you can switch your avatar. This is how you can check and see if your friends are online. So let's go through that one by one. So first and foremost, I would say before you do anything else in VRChat, go ahead and click on your safety settings. So now your safety settings are extremely important, especially if you're playing on PC. You want to make sure that they're calculated correctly so that you don't get crashed by other people, so that basically you can run at the most optimized performance you can go. And I recommend actually going with the safest settings first, seeing how your computer responds, and then you can bump it up from there. Bear in mind, depending on what your settings are, you might not be able to see certain custom animations. A lot of the time, custom animations are what take up a lot of your space on your computer. So right here, you see there's different categories. There's visitor, there's new user, known user, trusted user, and then friends. So I personally, I like to give my friends, the people I do friend, I like to give them everything because obviously I trust them. I trust they're not going to crash me. So I have all their things on. But then as you go down, a good rule of thumb for me is I just have only avatar and voice on, and then I unselect audio, lights, particles, you know, shaders, custom animations. I turn all of those off. So I'd recommend to all of you, go through visitor, new user, user, known user, and turn off everything except for voice and avatar. Yeah, just as a basis. And then as you go through the game, you can mess with these settings later on. But I just think as a start, it's a good way to go. I know in the beginning, especially when I went to public worlds, I was getting crashed a lot. And it's because these settings weren't optimized for my specific PC. I realize it's going to be different for everybody, but I feel like that's just a good thing to know and a good thing to start off with. Secondly, we can go up to performance options in the safety settings. And you have this thing called avatar performance and then dynamic bone. And if you click on both of these, you can kind of mess with the settings. So for avatar performance, I have mine on very poor just because that's as best as I can do. And then dynamic bone, you can limit dynamic bone usage. And again, this is basically it shows you, it's like what it's going to show for other avatars, and it's just going to make things easier for you if you lower those settings, and you can turn those off. But you don't have to. Again, you could mess with these settings. I'm just kind of making you aware of them. If you go into settings, just regular settings, you have a couple different options here. You can click off personal space, and that's going to affect whether or not certain avatars can get closer to you or not. You can toggle your voice. You can, switch your mic on and off if you want. Let's see, what else do we have here? So this one, the only other thing here is allow avatar cloning. So this one's interesting. If you want to allow people to clone your avatar, like let's say you go to a world, find a nice avatar, and other people are like, oh, hey, can I clone it? Like turn your cloning on. That's where you're going to find it here in settings, other options, and then allow avatar cloning. You can click that on or off. So that one's kind of useful. I don't really utilize anything else here. Obviously, you have your microphone volume there. You have the microphone that you're using. So I'm using, I should be using my Snowball. Where is it? There we go. So that's my Snowball mic. That's the one right here. And then you can turn your volume up or down depending on, if you want to ask people if they can hear you or not. And then mouse sensitivity, you can change that as well. Up here for audio volume. Now this one, I like to mess with this. I like to put the world volume down. A lot of the times when you go to a world, there'll be music playing and sometimes it's too loud. So you can come into here, turn down your world volume, and then you want to turn voices and avatars up because obviously if you want to be talking to other people, if it's a social game, you want to hear other people, mess with these settings, optimize them to where it's a good comfort level for you. It's just what I recommend. Now here's another thing. Within the settings, if you go up to advanced settings, this is something you're going to want to do quite often if you're maybe running on a laptop or a PC that's not as good. You know, if you run on a hamster PC like me, you'll notice up here you have a coach and it uses a certain amount of space. So right now I have 598.23 megabytes used. I'm going to want to clear all of that. And now it's clear, but if you're ever noticing that your avatars aren't loading very well, if it's taking you a long time to go into worlds, I'm just trying to help you look at all the different options for optimization to make sure you have smooth gameplay. I'd recommend going into your settings, going into advanced settings, and clearing or downloading your coach. Now, this is different than clear all local profile data. That's going to log you out, but if you just clear the downloaded coach, I'm not 100% sure what that is, because it's not going to get rid of your avatar. It's not going to get rid of your saved worlds. It's just going to get rid of a lot of temporary data. Now I'm throwing a lot of information at you, and I am sorry about that, but I'm trying to give you, a comprehensive understanding of everything about VRChat in as little amount of time as I can, so it's most effective. I didn't want to break it up into too many videos. So let's talk about changing avatars. So if you go into your settings and you click on avatar, you'll notice here you have a scroll wheel of all the different avatars you have. Now you can favorite avatars, and the way you do that, here I'll show you right now. So let's pretend Let's pretend I don't have any other avatars. I just loaded into the world. I come up here and I see this dog. And I go, great, I want that dog avatar. So it's gonna load up. And then I go, you know what? I like this, so I'm gonna go escape. I'm gonna go into avatar. And then down here, you see change and favorite. I'm gonna go ahead and click favorite. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna add it into the favorites up here. So see, there it is. It's got the gold star because it's favorited. So now I can leave this world, I can go to other places, and I know that this avatar is always there. All right, so now let's talk about worlds. So, you know, you're loaded into the home world here, and now I'm gonna show you how to go to different worlds, how to search for worlds, and kind of what the stats on these worlds mean. So right here is the worlds page. So this is gonna show you, VRChat categorizes it into different categories for you. So up at the top is hot, and that just means like these worlds are really popular at this moment. There's a Udon Alpha Spotlight. Sometimes they'll spotlight certain worlds that are new or certain worlds that VRChat thinks, you know, deserve a little bit more attention. Not 100% sure how they categorize those. But most importantly are the ones up at the top. These are the hot worlds. These are the ones with lots of people probably going to want to go to them. So you'll scroll through. Let's say I want to go to the Black Cat. So I'm going to click on the Black Cat. Now, there's a couple numbers here that appear that are pretty important. So right here, it shows me, next to this person icon, it shows me how many people are in this specific world. So 17 out of 18. So one more person can go to that world before it reaches max capacity. It's not going to let any more than 18 people into that world at any one time. Certain worlds will have different max numbers. Certain worlds maybe have 4. Other worlds will maybe have, you know, 30, 40. It all just really depends. Now, another thing to point out is if you look over here, there's something that says public. So different worlds can have, you know, different kind of like barriers to who can come and who can go. Let's pretend I wanted to create my own world. So I'd come over here and I'd click on new instance. So this is me creating a new instance of the Black Cat. I'm basically creating another copy of the Black Cat, but it's my world. I'm going to be the owner of it. And I can decide what setting I want to put for this world. And this is basically just like a gate for, you know, what limit do I want to put on what types of people I want to come to this world. And it explains it right here. So public, anyone can join. Friends plus, that's any friend of a friend. Just friends, obviously just friends. Invite plus means that it's only invite, but whoever you invite can also invite someone else. And then invite only is you're the one who's in control. This is the one that you would use if you want like maximum privacy. Like only you can accept or decline requests, and only you can send requests to other people. No one else can send them. So obviously the most secure, the most private type of world is invite only. Do that if you want it to be like, I don't know, a private conversation, or if you just want to be in a world by yourself, select that setting. And then obviously public if you don't really care. So you'll see down at the bottom here, it shows all the different instances of the Black Cat that are available. So you got, you know, 10 people in this world, 9 people in this world, 7 in that one, just one in that world. And it'll show you. It'll show you what they are. It'll show you if they're public, you know, friends plus, and it'll show up here. So now let's talk about actually going to worlds. So let's pretend I found the Black Cat. I see 10 out of 18 people. Cool. Maybe I want to go to something with a little bit less. 9 out of 18. Cool, that seems fine. So now there's two ways to get to it. There's go, which will just take me directly to that world, or there's another option that says drop portal. This is kind of useful. Let's say I want to do that. So I drop the portal. What's going to happen? So this now, this dropped a portal to that world. So you'll see public, 9 out of 18, and there's a little timer. There's 25 seconds to get into that world. I would use that if maybe I had some friends and, you know, I don't want to spend time inviting a bunch of people. I can just drop a portal and say, all right, everyone, into the Black Cat. We all head into that portal and, you know, off we go. And obviously it's going to disappear at the end of 25 seconds. We'll go ahead and wait for that to go away. Boom, and it's gone. Now, why would you not want to use drop portal? Well, let's say I'm in a public world with only a couple of people I want to go to the next world with. Let's say, you know, I'm in a world with 20 people. I only want to invite 4. So in that instance, I would just say, hey, I'm going to go to a new world. Join off me. What does that mean? What does it mean to join off someone else? So let's pretend I was in the Black Cat. right? And I had some friends, and I was like, all right, guys, I want to go to a new world, but I only want you guys coming with me. So I'm not going to drop a portal, because when you drop a portal, only certain people can come, unless you change the settings on what the portal is. So look here. I can go to world. I can go to Black Cat. I click on new instance, so I can make it maybe just friends, just invite plus. I'm going to make it just invite only. Look at that. So it changed it up here for invite only. Now I drop the portal. Now look. Now it's invite only. So only people that I want to have invited can go through that portal. I think that's how it works. I might be totally botching this. If you don't want to mess with portals, because I might be giving inaccurate information there. I'm not sure if that's 100% how that works. If you don't want to do that, you can just go to a world directly. So I'm just going to say, all right, new instance, invite only. I'm going to go. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to load up the Black Cat where it's just invite only. Instead of dropping a portal, I'm just going to this world directly. And then from there, I can go into my friends list and invite people into this world. And that's what I'm going to show you how to do right now. But obviously, if you have any questions, obviously, if you have any comments, obviously, if any of you want to help me out with that invite only drop portal, any of that, please comment down below. I just want to make this... I just want to put out good information for people who are playing VRChat on just PC. So let's go into this world. So now we're in the Black Cat, and it was invite only. So now I'm going to go here, go into social, and now I can look at my online friends. So these are the people I just friended. So you can only invite people who are your friends, I should also mention. So I can click on Dented. Let's pretend I want to have him come. So I'd go over here and I'd click on invites. He'd get an invite notice, and then he can join on me. That's pretty much how it works. Now let's get into the social aspect of VRChat. Let's go find a friend. Not literally. I don't think I'm going to be able to friend someone super quickly. But let's say hypothetically, you meet someone, and they're pretty cool. You're on PC, and you want to friend request them. I'm going to show you how to do that right now, hypothetically. So here we are in a public world. I've turned off voices so we don't have to hear these people's chatter, but yeah, so there's people hanging out over there, and I found this person over here in the corner, and I just want to show you how to friend request people and how to have other options in relation to one specific person. So if you press escape on PC and then hover over their avatar, a little blue tic-tac pill should appear, and I'm going to click on that, and when I do that, that's going to bring up this person's avatar preferences. So over here you can see I can friend request them if I want. I can show or hide their avatar. I can turn their voice on or off. If I need to block them, I can. And if you want to clone someone's avatar, if you see someone's avatar you like and you want to clone it, the options here. But yeah, that's pretty much it for that. Otherwise, hopefully this was useful for all of you guys. If you have any questions or comments, please put them down below. I enjoyed playing VRChat on the PC. I'm sure all of you will as well. I can't wait to get a VR headset. I know that VRChat's obviously way more fun with VR versus just on PC. But it is a good social game, you know, it's a good crack. So yeah, thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Thanks. Bye-bye.